It's black, it's white, it's wrong, it's right. Ethics, they're the standard of what is right and wrong, and it's based on our values. Being ethical requires making a moral judgment, and that's not always easy. Ethical behavior takes courage, and it needs to be practiced. Middle. Middle is a word we all know, but we often overlook it. Middle is a fair place where everything is taken into account, and both sides of the story are analyzed and evaluated. No one is completely good or completely bad. Most of the time in our day-to-day lives, we don't even think about ethics, though that we display our ethical values and our core values without even realizing it. Though, sometimes we may find ourselves facing a decision and thinking, what should I do? If there's a law, it's easy, follow it. If your instincts tell you to do something, it's easy, follow your gut. But sometimes the choice isn't always so clear. Sometimes there's no rule or law to follow. For example, should I stay loyal to a colleague even if I think he's wrong? In this, there's no clear distinction between right or wrong. Ethics. Whatever decision we make will be based on our ethics, on our core values. It's the choices and decisions we make that define us, not the title good or bad. Today, I'm going to share a story from the Indian mythology Mahabharata. The Mahabharata is a story about the struggle for sovereignty between two groups of cousins, the Kauravas and the Pandavas. The Pandavas are the sons of Kunti. Today, I'm talking about a character from the story called Karna. He's the eldest son of Kunti and the sun god Ra. He was abandoned at birth by his unwed mother and was raised by the charioteer Adhirath. Karna, he grew to be a very gifted and skilled archer, and he took part in many archery competitions. At one of these tournaments, the Guru Kripacharya humiliated Karna, and Duryodhan, the eldest of the Kauravas, immediately defended him and made him king of Anga. Karna immediately pledges allegiance and friendship to Duryodhan because Duryodhan saved him from continuous humiliation, a source of continuous hardship. This incident was the start of a firm friendship between the two, and they became as close as brothers. So why would he take the side of a family who shunned him rather than a friend who treated him as family? This story tells us people can only be judged by their circumstances. With black and white mentality, people often overlook the mistakes or the wrong actions of the good and stress on every action of the bad. This mentality is the reason why people believe that there's plain right and plain wrong, and no reason or circumstances are taken into account. Ethical dilemmas, they provide a choice between competing values. Ethical dilemmas provide a choice between right versus right. So what should we do when an ethical dilemma comes? First thing we can do is follow the law. It sounds obvious, right? But most people don't even realize they get in trouble because they don't follow it. Second thing we can do is realize when we're in an ethical dilemma. By doing this, we may want to resolve the issue. And for doing this, we should gather all the facts and analyze and compare both the sides. While analyzing your options, you may find yourself thinking, I wish there was a third choice. A choice, a compromise position that holds true to my ethical principles. A choice in the middle. There are many ways we can solve ethical dilemmas. The first being, follow your instincts. What does your gut tell you? What do you feel in the pit of your stomach? Second, ends-based. What does the most good and the least amount of harm? Third, law. Follow the law. In this, there won't be any legal consequence, but it may not be true to our ethical principles. 4. Care-based. What would I do if I was in the other person's shoes? 5th. Fairness or justice. Treat people equally. Think about all the groups of people who are at stake with your decision. And then make your decision. You don't have to do this alone. Heed advice from the people whose judgment you respect. And then act. And then the last step may be the most important. Reflect. Reflection. If this choice comes again, will I make the same decision, knowing the consequences? It will help prepare us for the inevitable tough choices that will present themselves again in our life. I would like to end with, it's black, it's white, it's wrong, it's right. Most of the world is neither, most of the world is grey, most of the world is different, and that is perfectly okay. Thank you.